Can you do a split? Can you do a split? What it is? When I used to live in Tunisia, so I want to say, guys, do you actually see this huge ass, like, moth? Not even a moth. That's a bee. That's a bee. Bye. I've never taken self-defense classes. Daddy, you can't speak when I'm filming. What's going on? Why are you in my video? You're in my video again. Daddy, you can't see that. Oh my god. Welcome back to my channel, guys. So today I'm gonna be filming a get to know me tag with a bunch of questions that I found online. So I'm just gonna read the questions off of my laptop and then yeah, y'all can get to know me or whatever. Let's get into the video. First question is, what's my full name? My full name is Amira. Okay, I actually have two names. I low-key have a made-up name, and then I have my actual name. So, all of my sisters and I share the same middle name, but growing up, I really didn't like it, so I changed my middle name and made my own middle name. So, obviously, my full name is Amira Uni, and my middle name is Anyo. So, it's spelled Anya, but you pronounce it Anyo, so it's Amira Anyo Uni, but, when I was younger, I changed my middle name to Alexandra, and it's been that way ever since. So, Amira Alexandra Uni. My name means princess in Arabic, so I'm Muslim, and all my sisters and I have Arabic names. So yeah, Amira in Arabic means princess. So I'm originally from Ghana, Accra, Ghana. Represent, bra, bra, bra. So yeah, so I'm originally from Accra, Ghana, but I'm a third culture kid. So if you don't know what that is, I basically have lived all around the world in every country except where I'm from. So yeah. So where did I grow up? Because earlier on I did say that I am a third culture kid, essentially that means I grew up everywhere. So I'm just gonna go through it really quickly because I just went through it and I even got myself confused. Basically, was born in Gambia, moved to Ivory Coast, moved back to Ghana. From Ghana, I moved to Tunisia, lived there. And then from Tunisia, I moved to London, lived there for like 2 years, then moved back to Tunisia where I lived for like a good 7 years of my life. And then after Tunisia, I moved to South Africa. And that was where I became a Joburger. Like, anyway. Moving on! My favorite things about myself are... Okay, first we're gonna do looks-wise, then we're gonna do my favorite characteristics. Looks-wise, I'll have to say my nose. I used to really hate my nose, but now I kinda... I fuck with it, like I love it. But, so yeah, my nose. I really like my stomach. Like, when I'm properly fit and I'm working out and being healthy, I have, like... My abs come together really well, if I do say so myself. So, yeah, I'd have to say my nose, my stomach, and my lips. Yeah, I'm actually so fucking jarred. Oh my god. Characteristics-wise, my favorite thing about myself is that I'm very optimistic. Like, it's a bit annoying how optimistic I can be, but I'm super optimistic, and I think that's just, it's like a great thing to have in life, because no matter, you know, trials and tribulations of life, whatever the fuck happens, I know that at the end of the day, I still got me, and like, I'm moving on to bigger and better things. So that's one of like my life mottos that I like to live by, moving on to bigger, better things. It's going to be okay. Like, guys, no matter what it is, it's actually gonna be fine, don't worry. And yeah, another thing is that I'm very, I'm kind of a comedian, so I'd say my humor, I really like my optimism and my humor. How many siblings do you have? So I have three sisters, three older sisters, and that's it. I only have girls in my family, so we're kind of hectic. My dad probably hates us, but it is what it is. What is my biggest fear? My biggest fear has to be I don't know what to tell you. I'm not afraid of anything. Bad bitch vibes. Just kidding. My biggest fear is my parents, like my immediate family passing away prematurely, I guess, and then my parents not being able to live long enough to see me succeed. That would be my biggest fear. What inspires me the most? I would say what inspires me the most has to be my father. Just because, you know, his life story growing up, it really came from nothing, and he was able to amass such like wealth for me, my family, and take care of us and put us in the best schools and everything like that, and he's just really inspiring. So, you know, I'd like to be like that. And he's always just shown me that like you should never really give up, and if you want to do something, there's like, no matter what, no matter how hard it is, if you set your mind to it, you can definitely achieve it. So I've always sort of tried to live by that. So yeah. My favorite musician, Frank Ocean. Done. Okay? Frank fucking. I got the best feeling when you said you love me. Frank Ocean is my nigga, bitches. Let me tell you that. Anyway. I'm actually so fucking drunk. I'm embarrassing. I'm annoying. Bye. My favorite color is purple. I fucking love purple. Royalty. You know the vibes. You know what it do. You know how it be. There's actually something wrong with me. I don't understand. My favorite food has to be pasta. Like, I literally eat, let me not even get started, because guys, it's bad. Like, the amount of carbs that I can eat any sort of pasta. Like, I don't care. Anything, just give it to me and I'll eat it. Trust me. My favorite song used to be Man in the Mirror, but the Keke Palmer version. Kiki. Yeah, my queen. Anyway, so I used to really love Man in the Mirror. Then If I'm in Love by Frank Ocean. Guys, if you listen to that song, Beats headphones. If I'm in Love, Frank Ocean. Lights off. Strip lights on. A little done. My favorite quote is, she believed she could, so she did. And also, if you want it done well, do it yourself, bitches. What else? Life is a constant process of dying. Because it's true, you know, facts. What is your favorite way to pass time? It used to be reading. I really love reading. Like, especially if it's like a really fucking like, a good romance book. I was really into the 50 Shades of Grey trilogy. Was it a trilogy? Yeah, guys, When I tell you, I was obsessed with those books. And the age, I was really reading this like 8th grade. Bitch, what are you doing? Go to after school classes. Actually, that's what you should be doing. Thank you. What was your favorite subject in high school? IB? Favorite? Boy, bye. Bye. Just kidding. My favorite IB subject, I know this is gonna sound crazy, especially for the bitches who were in, like whoever took HL IB history, but it was HL history. And then Langlet, and that's it, yeah. HL history and Langlet and IB, love those. My least favorite subjects in high school had to be HL Econ. Are you fucking joking? I literally tried to drop it. They told me, you can't, bitch. They said you have to graduate taking economics! What was your favorite TV show when you were a child? Favorite TV show when I was a child? The Simpsons. That wasn't really when I was a child, but I'd say The Simpsons. Otherwise, I'd probably say Desperate Housewives or Grey's Anatomy. Like, I was one of those kids that didn't like to watch kids' shows when I was a kid. Like, I thought I was, like, super grown, like, on my shit. Like, you can't tell me nothing, bitch. So I was like, yeah, Grey's Anatomy, fucking Desperate Housewives, Juanita, bitch. I'm jarred. I understand, don't worry. I don't think so. I would not say that I'm high maintenance. Definitely not. Maybe slightly. I just like what I like. I wouldn't necessarily. No. No! High maintenance? Come on. Yes. Yes, I am. Are you a dog or a cat person? I'm actually not. Okay. Realistically, I'm a dog person. I used to have a cat. My cat didn't like me. Nettles did not fuck with me, and that's just a fact. So, kind of have PTSD from my old cat. I like dogs if they're not like vicious and not trying to bite me, because I can't be doing that. Are you a fan of any sports team? Yes. I follow the English Premier League. I'm a really big fan of it. Really big Arsenal supporter, yes. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. Because actually, we're coming back 2020. So, let's go Gunners! I sleep with my lights off. Sleeping with your lights on, you're literally a serial killer. Like, I'm sorry. What? Ted Bundy? I'm more of a... This is the thing. I'm not really a cuddly person, but I am when I am. Like, do you get? Like, you know when you're in the mood to cuddle and you're like, oh yeah, like I can cuddle? If I'm not in the mood to cuddle and someone touches me, I will actually like get you arrested. I hate being touched. I'm provoked. I'm not a touchy person, so don't do that. But yeah. Weirdly enough, I'd still have to say cuddling. Even though I just went on this whole spiel about I fucking hate cuddling, don't touch me. Yeah. Actually, I like both. Bitch, the fuck? I didn't gotta pick the book. It's hard. No, I don't believe in love at first sight. I believe in lust at first sight, but love at first sight is a bit much. It's a bit much. What? My first boyfriend?
Cut the cameras. Dead end.
I don't know what you're asking. Boyfriend? Who would you tell first if you saw a dead body in the garden? Bitch, what the fuck? The police. Who? Guys, remember, please, though, I'm a law student. You will not catch me going to... I will snitch. That's all I'm saying. I will snitch. For what? For who? Prison time for who? Bye. Sorry. I switched. My star sign. Try and guess what my star sign is. Try and guess what my star sign is. I'm a Sagittarius, of course. That's why I'm fucking amazing. Why the fuck do you think I look this good? Something with like an activity. I love a good activity. Here's the thing. If you're taking me on an activity date, just because we're going on a date does not mean I'll forfeit. Like, I'm not gonna lose for fun. Sorry, what? My mom did not raise no punk ass bitch. I will win. In fact, I will serve you, but still cute. Yeah, so anything really that has an activity in it, I'm down for. I don't really like a dinner and a movie on a first date. Maybe like third date. At the furthest third date, but first or second date, it's too much. Okay, something that I look for in a partner. Well, right now I'm not really looking for a partner. I'm just living my single life, my best life, really. But I just want someone who's honest, loyal, funny, 6 foot and taller, and someone that isn't trash. So if you find that person, you must call me. So anything really that has an activity in it, I'm down for. I don't really like a dinner and a movie on a first date. Maybe like third date, at the furthest third date, but first or second date, it's too much. Like, is this a meeting? Do you have any tattoos? No, I do not. It's haram in Islam, so not gonna see me doing that. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave any recommendations for video ideas that you wanna see next in the comment section below. And yeah, I'll catch you guys next time. Like, comment, and subscribe. Bye. Flinch bitch.